when we were growing up,
आपने
there's always a message that's given to us that we're supposed to always be happy, right? And I know there's a lot of songs, even down in Tamil, referring to always be happy, things like that, right? And you're supposed to feel good. You're supposed to only actually, you're not supposed to, girls specifically, you're not supposed to get angry and shout at another person. And for guys, you're not supposed to cry.
Chat with Champions featuring Revathi Hariharan, psychologist, MSc psychology gold medalist. Podcast on air. Use headphones for better sound. So hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Ganesh Natarajan. இன்னைக்கு இந்த பாட்காஸ்ட் சாட் வித் சாம்பியன்ஸ் அப்படிங்கிற சீரீஸ்ல யாரு கூட இருக்கும்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா ரேவதி ஹரிஹரன். இவங்களை நான் எப்படி இன்ட்ரடியூஸ் பண்றதுன்னு எனக்கே தெரியல. ஒரு சைக்கலாஜிஸ்ட் இன்ட்ரடியூஸ் பண்றதா, இல்ல வந்து ஒரு கோல்டு மெடலிஸ்ட் இன்ட்ரடியூஸ் பண்றதா. இவங்க வந்து எனக்கு ஒரு பயோ கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. அந்த பயோல படிச்சா எனக்கே நிறைய விஷயங்கள் புரிய மாட்டேங்குது. கிளினிக்கல், ஹைப்போ, ஏதேதோ இருக்கு. ஸோ எனிவே, லெட்ஸ் வெல்கம் ரேவதி. வெல்கம் ரேவதி.
Hello Ganesh, thank you so much for having me at the clinical hypnotherapy.
First, let us introduce a topic to the viewers, right? Today's topic is decoding emotions. Is positive emotions overhyped? That is what we are going to see in this podcast, right? So first, let me ask you, what is an emotion and what are the various types of emotion?
To start with, what are emotions? So emotions, to basically put it, if you actually break down the word, right, it has two major words, right? One is E and there's emotion. So E is something that refers to energy that's always present in everything that we see around, okay? And in living organisms, it's an energy that's constantly moving. So and the component of motion refers to the component of movement. So anything and energy in movement is actually emotion. Okay, to put it down, there are three major components that emotion actually has to understand whether you're feeling something and what is that you're going through. Okay, so one is a component of a situation. So when we're normally there, we don't usually feel many things, or we are not usually aware as to what is that we're feeling. Right? Something happens around. This is the situation. Okay, let's say I'm sitting in my house. I don't really care about what I'm feeling or what I'm thinking. Okay. But I suddenly see my mom and dad fight. Okay, this is an example that I'm going to give you, right? So what happens, you feel like, oh, what just happened, right? So there's a situation. And then what happens, once you start approaching the situation, or once you actually see it or sense it that there's a situation that's happening, you start actually appraising it. That means to say, okay, you start perceiving it. Like, okay, what is happening? Is it because of me that they're fighting? Did something go wrong in the house? Okay. Or are they fighting always, right? So you perceive it in some way. After you perceive it, what happens is it actually makes you feel certain things in your body. So if you get really scared because of your parents fighting, what you tend to feel is fear, right? So you actually start sweating and you start feeling like a little dry and butterfly in your stomach. You cannot move, right? But if you're actually getting angry because your parents are fighting often and you've already told them multiple times, please don't fight, but they still continue doing that, what happens is like you get irritated, right? And then you actually want to like go right to them and like start shouting at them. So your heartbeat is going up. You actually are throwing up in the sense that your body is moving a lot because you're angry. So there's always a physiology to it. And the third main component is there's a change in the behavior, okay? Usually, I'm just there around. People don't notice me. I'm just doing my own stuff. But there is a change in the emotion. Okay, depending on the emotion that we feel, there is a change in the behavior also. Like when I'm happy, maybe I'll be singing around or I'm just dancing around in the house. Okay, but when I'm actually feeling sad or angry, the behavior of mine will also change. Right? Maybe when I get angry, I'm a little like silent. I want to keep myself isolated. I don't want to talk to people. Or like when I'm really like angry to the peak, I just want to go or like shout at people, say nasty things to others. So like this, when you feel different emotions, there are always three important components that we always have to remember. The basic of every emotion is the component of where you feel there is a situation that happens. And how is that you look at the situation? And then there's a definite bodily change that's going to happen. Whether you actually accept it or you don't accept it, There's a change in the body that's going to happen, and then there'll be a change in your behavior. So this is how an emotion actually works. Okay. Now to answer the second part of your question, which actually focuses on the types of emotions. So basically, to broadly put it, we actually have two major types of emotions. One is a positive emotion and the other one is a negative emotion. So these are the broad classifications of emotions per se. Yeah.
Fantastic. Fantastic, Revati. That was a fantastic explanation that you gave. So you talked about positive emotion and negative emotion. So what can be categorized into the positive emotion and what can be categorized into negative emotion?
Okay. So let me decode what positive as well as negative emotion means. Okay. So just to get your idea towards it. So when I say the word positive, so what do you feel? What do you think about it? Immediately what comes to your mind when I say the word positive?
Okay, like, this gives a good feeling. Out. Which gives a good feel.
Exactly. So what happens is, right, let me address this part in two ways, okay? Just to take your initial answer out, it makes you feel good, okay? I'm just going to tweak it a little bit. A positive emotion is something that's going to make you feel pleasant. Instead of actually putting the word good there, I'm just going to tell you it's going to make you feel pleasant, okay?
Okay.
After you did something, when you actually experience a positive emotion, you actually feel, okay, maybe I did a good job, right? Or you actually feel, okay, okay, it's accomplished, something like that. Okay, something that makes you feel pleasant, even when you're experiencing the emotion or after some time when you're sitting back and reflecting upon it, okay? So most of the positive emotions that we generally know start with happiness and then it goes on to a state of elation, euphoric, bliss, proud, excited. These are the commonly referred to positive emotions that we have. And then coming back to negative emotions. So negative, actually, when you hear the word negative, most of them tend to associate with something that's bad or something that you're not supposed to have or feel. Right? That is not the case. I'll explain why that is not the case in the later. But just to give you a broad clarity right now, a negative emotion is any emotion that actually makes you feel unpleasant. Okay, or it causes a component of displeasure in you. Okay, either when you're feeling the emotion or right after some time when you start reflecting upon it. Like to say, like certain negative emotions that we have are sadness, anger, irritation, frustration, guilt, right? So what happens is when you experience the emotion, you actually feel it's actually causing a lot of discomfort in you. Okay, when you get angry or when you get sad, you actually feel this. So I'm not feeling that good or like that okay, right? It actually affects your state of mind. And then what happens is even when you reflect upon it, like for example, I got angry today, I shouted at another person, okay? So in the process of shouting at another person, I actually feel this discomfort. But even after coming home and sitting and thinking about the incident, even then it actually makes me feel, okay, why did I actually do this? Right? I should have instead talked to the person instead of shouting at them. Right? Even after you experiencing that emotion, it actually causes a component of discomfort in you. So these are certain positive as well as negative emotions. And an extension answer to it is, usually when people actually come to meet you in therapy sessions or even outside, I see a lot of children and like even adolescents are given this message, right? Very early in their life, even like when we were growing up, there's always a message that's given to us that we're supposed to always be happy, right? And I know there's a lot of songs, even down in Tamil, referring to always be happy, things like that, right? And you're supposed to feel good, you're supposed to only actually, you're not supposed to, girls specifically, you're not supposed to get angry and shout at another person, and for guys, you're not supposed to cry. Right? So these are things that are said to all of us, right? So what happens is most of the times, most kids and most people, when you meet them, they actually tend to have an opinion that they're just supposed to feel a positive emotion. They're not supposed to get any negative emotion, right? Because they feel positive means it's good and negative means it's bad. But that's not the case. Yeah? Like when you actually see how and why emotions develop and what is the reason why we have emotions, then we go a little back according to evolutionary perspective. Okay? So what happens here is, initially when we were living in the olden days, right, we didn't have the comfort of living in the house to keep ourselves safe and having a separate forest like we do right now, right? People back then were actually living in the jungle or inside the forest or things like this. So they actually were living with other species which could harm them at any moment, right? And certain emotions were there to actually make us feel safe and also to protect us, okay? Just to give you an example, in the olden days when people were living in the forest or in a jungle or in any place which was not as comfortable as we are right now, right? So what happens, they usually see a lot of reptiles, some of which could actually cause a lot of harm to you and potentially kill you, right? So when they saw a snake, okay, they actually got this emotion of fear. And that's how they actually went inside or killed it to actually keep themselves safe. Right? And that's how they actually protected themselves as well as their loved ones. And that's how it works even today. Even though we are living in a very like confined way and like in a lot of comfort, right? But even these emotions, like you see a lot of children having this fear of dogs or fear of any animals, right? Or fear of any situations, those of actually have an evolutionary reason towards it. Okay. If we don't have that fear, what we'll do, we'll go and start petting an animal which you're not supposed to pet, or the animal is not going to take it in the right stride. And there are chances that you'll get hurt, right? So that's how emotions were of great importance. So one thing that I would like to say is not just don't go with the terms or the labels just because it's called positive and it's called negative. It doesn't actually mean good and bad. It just means it's going to make you feel pleasant, it's going to make you feel unpleasant. But whether it's going to help you, whether it is healthy, that's something that we have to think about. That's very important.
Okay. So for the viewers, what Revati is saying is, she's suggesting that it's okay to have the negative emotions. She very well explained how evolutionarily the emotions developed and all those things. Here is a very different and unique question, Revati. What positive role does negative emotions play in a person's life? Because negative emotions are considered to be, something that a person should not have in their life. So I'm twisting the question. What positive role does negative emotion play in a person's life?
Okay. So what I'm trying to say here is, the whole component of labeling and all the messages that's been given, right, from a very young age, actually makes you feel, okay, you're supposed to have a positive component of out of a negative situation or a negative thing, right? But that's not usually the scenario that it is. Right?
That's true.
Sometimes a negative emotion is negative, but it actually has a purpose, right? We have to understand what is the purpose of an emotion. What purpose is an emotion serving? Okay. So let's say, for example, you have certain negative emotions, okay, like that of your fear or that of your getting anxiety or like getting anxious at times, okay. So let me give you a brief example. I already gave you the example of fear, like how in case you don't have this fear, you tend to go near an animal and there are chances that it can bite you or it can harm you and leading to a lot of other problems, right? Now let me give you an example of feeling anxious, okay. So anxiety or feeling anxious is actually a negative emotion, right? But for example, let's say, since I gave an example of a kid earlier, let's say your boss tells you that there is a performance review that's going to happen. Okay. And everybody's performance is going to get reviewed and the people who are not performing well or not meeting the standard will be actually laid off from the company. Okay. Given today's time. So actually then after hearing this, what you actually feel is the component that you actually tend to get anxious, right? Because there are chances that that person who's going to get laid off could be you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So then what you do, this feeling of anxiousness or the anxiety that you feel actually helps you to take a pause and reflect and perform better. It actually makes you to feel. It actually makes you to actually think and also enhance your performance to know what are some of the areas that I can do better, how is that I can do better, because it's an evaluation that's going to happen. Okay?
Mm.
So you start putting a little more effort. That anxiety is actually triggering you to put in your extra effort. Right? So that will actually enhance your performance.
Mm.
Okay? For example, if you're too casual about it, okay, or your boss comes and tells you this and you're too casual, oh, I'm not going to do, nothing is going to happen to me. So you feel like, I'm not supposed to experience any negative emotions. Okay.
Hmm.
So let me just, when I get the feeling anxiety or feeling anxious only, okay, let me like just run away from it. Okay. Okay. I'm not feeling anxious. Let me feel happy. Oh, there's a performance evaluation that's going to happen. Okay. Happy.
Hmm.
Okay. Let me do everything that I want to do. Let me chill. Let me have fun.
Hmm.
But in that case, there are chances sometimes you will not take it so seriously, right? And you will just go with the flow and there will be someone who will put that extra effort and you could be the next person who could be terminated, right? But when you're getting a little anxious, when it's in the moderate level, right? That actually is helpful, right? And let's go back to history, right? Mm. Anger. Mm. This is one emotion, like negative emotion, that most parents tell you not to feel this, right?
Mm.
Not supposed to get angry. This is a message that we get very early in our lives, right? Especially from parents or from elders in the house, right? Not supposed to get angry at anybody, at anything, for any reason, okay? But let me ask you a question. So you know all the freedom fighters, right? Who actually fought for the freedom of the country?
Mm.
Okay,
yeah.
So didn't they get actually angry at the British for how they were treating us? And
don't you think
the anger actually triggered them to actually initiate this freedom movement?
Yeah, that's a very interesting point that you have given here. And also, I feel what you're saying is absolutely 100% true. Tomorrow,
yeah.
I'm giving you a scenario. Tomorrow is your board exam and you have not prepared. And especially, do you think media is, media and all these channels, platforms, you said films, you mentioned that songs are promoting this. Do you think they are also promoting?
Yeah, it actually starts in a very early age, right? Even the messages, like certain messages that we get from our parents actually starts forming our, these are things that I'm supposed to do. Like when you said also, you actually use the word should, right?
Mm.
And you said shouldn't, right?
Mm.
These are like certain codes. Like when I say you should feel this, you shouldn't feel this, then what happens when you actually feel something that is a natural reaction to the situation, but in your mind, you have this message from your father or your mother or from significant other saying that, oh, you shouldn't feel this. So you're giving two different messages. Your heart is actually feeling something. Your brain is giving a message, oh, you shouldn't. Then you don't know what you're supposed to do. Whether you experience it, you run away from it, you suppress it, you avoid it. That's where it actually causes a problem. Okay?
Yeah.
So one important aspect is, see, negative emotions are negative emotions because they serve a purpose. Okay? So every emotion, positive as well as negative, actually serves a purpose. Okay? It's very important for us to understand what purpose is the emotion serving. Okay? So if you know there is a negative emotion that you are experiencing and you feel in this situation, this is a healthy emotion or an appropriate reaction to the situation. Okay, like you see someone hurting another person in the road, okay? You tending to get angry is okay to help another person. Even though you felt the negative emotion of anger in that place, it's actually helped you to take a step for another person, right? Not just like pass by. Right?
Hmm.
So in that situation, even though the emotion was negative in nature, it served a purpose and it was appropriate in the situation. So that is exactly what we're supposed to think about. Sometimes, like the question that you asked, right? To extend it a little further, sometimes even all the positive emotions that we feel, right? Actually, can be unhealthy. Okay? To give you an example, let's say I actually love rains. Okay, I actually love playing in the rain. And
okay.
I also love ice cream. Okay.
Okay.
So let's say, suppose it actually rains suddenly today.
Mm.
And I feel like having an ice cream. Or there's an ice cream in my house. Okay.
Mm.
So what I do, I'm actually eating a lot of ice cream. Then I see it's raining heavily. And I have this positive emotion of excitement. Okay.
Mm.
So without thinking that tomorrow I have work there are a lot of work that I have to do, right? I have to report. The situation is not right. There's COVID cases. There are people dying and things like this, okay? If I'm not thinking about all of this, I see a rain and I go down and start dancing in the rain, okay? And if I fall sick, even though the emotions is passing, right, it can have a negative impact on my life. Or it can lead to an inappropriate situation in my life. So sometimes even the positive emotions, the so-called positive emotions that we are too much hyping about, right? If it is not appropriate in a given situation, there are chances that you will land into trouble because of this.
Subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon to never miss an update on any of the videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.